Teddy is a homo. He's gender fluid. Look at this cute dog and George Thorogood's not that bad looking at her. Looks like I got drafted by the Chargers, but I forget what that guy's name was. I told them Manning was a clown, and I was the best quarterback in town. San Diego, meow, meow, meow. I think I wore 17. Greg Death just thought of it, because George Thorogood likes like Brian Leaf. Saxophone's lame. Like, every time, it's kind of sad, you can hear, like, you know, Lonesome George is soloing. That is Ryan Leaf, by the way. It's always fourth down. I throw lots of picks and I drown in Vicodin. Sick guitar player, dude. Move over, Peyton Manning, because Ryan Leaf is here again. Are you looking at Natron Means that right there? We had Junior Seau. What do you say when our middle linebacker hits you? You say ow. But then he got that brain disease and lost a lot of cartilage in his knees. Lots of tackles. He was like wine or some shit, and he was inside linebacker who shot himself in the head. Hey, Greg Death, I think you lied. He shot himself in the heart because he wanted them to diagnose his brain cells. So he shot himself in the chest. All right, that was a tangent. Meow, meow, meow. It was meow, meow. Check him out. We got... that was so sick. It's like... what the fuck was that guy's name? Mark Hamill? Was he a figure skater? We had some Olympic nigga that was tight in like 84. Obviously, Mary Lou Retton was just the real shit. All fucking 1.6 meters of her. Don't even know if that's tall. She was sick though. I love Vicodin. And I hate Peyton Manning. This is like 2 hours before kickoff and I'm drunk in a bar at 11 again. This time we will play the Browns and even Tim Couch will get first downs. Oh, I guess their defense wasn't. Meow, 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 meow. Ladies and gentlemen. Tedster. Alright, what's this autoplay gonna do? I'm gonna play some nerdy shit. So this is my random thought for the night. I'm dog sitting for my boss because I need all the brownie points I can get constantly. Do very little at work. But I'm nice to this guy. And my cat, I had to give my cat some enhanced interrogation tonight. So she's resting on her college dorm room ironing board that's also used for waterboarding cats. But real talk, Maggie's around here somewhere. She's lounging. How do I very succinctly put this? I'm going to sound like super gay. I'm like emo now. It is kind of an emotional thing. Like when you just kick it with a dude like this, you guys are both falling asleep. He's like such a good boy. He's so handsome. He's gentle. And I can't help but, you know, I think so. Really, I'm going to stand by this. Like if you could be cruel to these animals, right? Like, if a dog gets, you know, if it bites or, if it just keeps getting in the garbage or something, you may like smack them on the nose or something. But if you're just, fucking evil to beings like this, I say we collectively just, like, whatever the kids call it now, dox. Like, just dox the living dog shit out of these people. If you see them, like, because they're going to be in the paper. You go to the website and just everybody, like, learn the names and faces of the subhumans out there that would, like, throw him out of a moving car or chain him with, you know, 3 feet of length and leave him out in the Houston sun. It's fucking evil. And so, yeah, if you work at Burger King, give them 5 nuggets, learn their faces. Just, like, don't fuck with them. Like, don't fuck with them both ways. Like, I'm not advising, like, violence towards these people, right? That's probably what they deserve. But I'm serious. Like, if enough people just refused services, like, made sure their employers were checking the papers and, like, see that, so, you know, some dude fucking cut a pit bull puppy's feet off on the internet because some people like to jack off to that. They don't get a lot of jail time. And I could probably kill one of my pretty good friends before I could kill a dog. You know what I mean? At least I could explain it to my friend, be like, dude, I would have to, like, kill Megan, or, like, he would get it. Like, all right, just, like, one right between the eyes. Like, it wouldn't, like, torture him or whatever. But, yeah, it's just hard to imagine. I know I'm rambling now. But, yeah, if that could get one of these pieces of shit, like, not help get, like, changing his tire, like, because you're in fucking, lower, what would it be called, like, South Davenport, Iowa, or some shit, you know what I mean, and you just have, like, see homeboy, like, stuck in a cornfield, drunk, and, like, somebody recognizes you, like, yeah, that's a fucking dude that, you know, drowned kittens because he was pissed off at his girlfriend, you know what I mean, he lives in that double wide down there, whatever, and I'm stereotyping, but, like, yeah, it could be rich people, poor people. I don't think wealthy people really do that. But, yeah, man, there's, like, middle-aged people, young cats, whatever. Whoever is just doing fucked up shit to cats and dogs. Like, if you don't want animals, don't like, seek them out. Don't have one and just chain it to your backyard. Like, it's... Or else people are going to short you at Burger King if they recognize you. All the way up to making sure you lose your job or something. So, you know, obviously, use some discretion and don't, like, I'm not advising, like, a proactive approach. I think you guys get me. I'm probably over-explaining this. But just if we all knew, I haven't done this yet, by the way, so I'm not preaching. It was just an idea I had that if, like, even if, like, you know, 15 people in, like, every town or whatever kind of just, like, checked on it. They have, you know, names, addresses, and stuff like that. So, don't go fucking looking for trouble, because these pieces of shit will probably pull a trigger on you, too. It's not like that. It's just, like, if you agree with me that it's just incomprehensible, I can wrap my head around, seriously, almost any other crime. You understand? You feel me? Crimes of passion, crimes for monetary gain, for sure. Like, you know, I could see doing a forceful armed robbery at a bank. If you were really good at it, you know what I'm saying? Like, the dudes who used to get away with it, it's really hard to do it now. But in the 90s, man, you go in and just fucking fire a Mac-10 into a Los Angeles Bank of America and demand motherfuckers get on the ground and usually not kill anybody, you know? And so, yeah, it was really effective. So yeah, that's a fucked up crime, and you absolutely could kill a human being even by accident. You shoot up through the freaking roof with a fucking machine gun, by the way, in Los Angeles in the 90s, like, you know, Miami, Philadelphia, walk into a bank, you and your buddy, or you by yourself, even better, off the street, already in a ski mask with gloves on and a fucking extendo clip on a Mac-10. And, fucking pump shotgun. Throw two slugs through the roof. Yeah, if, like, you could kill an electrician or fucking anything horrible could go wrong. So, that will get you, like, attempted armed robbery or attempted armed robbery, you know, first strike, I'm thinking, yeah, there's some light sentences, but they still take that shit pretty seriously. Like, if they have room in the jails and stuff. So, if you did that once, didn't even hurt anybody, but you got caught for an attempted robbery with force, like, you'd probably do, like, if it was your very first offense, for at least, like, 4.5 to 8 years or something consecutively with, you know what I mean? Very serious. And then, like, what do you get? Like a $50 fine? If I would take Teddy and chain him on 3 feet of rope and let him get fleas, let him get sunburnt, let him dehydrate. That's what'll kill him first. 106 degrees, like, fucking people that do that are just, don't need any help from, like, humans. Teddy, he's, like, got a new wave haircut. He's a little weirdo. Maybe I will be mean to him. I get it now. Good boy. Handsome boy. All right. Disco Greg at FNPR Houston.